My guest tonight is one of the greatest and most beloved American singer-songwriters. He says you, he says me, he says watch him on the season finale of American Idol Sunday night on ABC. Please welcome Lionel Richie. Hi, Lionel. How are you?
Jimmy, how are you? I'm doing very well. I'm kind of honored to be like the only guest. I love this. I get to talk the whole segment.
I wouldn't want to talk to anyone but you, Lionel. You've had a big resurgence in my house because I've started playing your songs for my 5-year-old daughter.
Oh, that's good.
And she loves them. And I've had to explain, like, Jumbalidi said to Moya. You know, had to translate that for her, but she's learning it.
That could be a little difficult to a 5-year-old. Like, what does that mean? Yeah.
What does that mean, Lionel? I know I've asked you before, and it doesn't really mean anything, does it?
The truth of the matter is it means nothing.
Yes.
I just realized in my creating that song, it's, there are 101 African dialects, and by the time I figured out which one was going to be the one to use, I said, I'll make up one. So that's it.
You know what? It means what it sounds like it means. It means fun is what it means.
That's exactly right.
During this quarantine, have you considered growing your giant Afro back? Has that crossed your mind at any moment?
You know, whether I considered it or not, it is coming back with great vigor.
I understand.
And I am happy at this age and time in my life that there is an Afro coming back. Thank you very much. So that's the good thing. So I'm a little afraid to cut it right now. It may jinx the whole thing. But it's working out very well. And I can always tell when Afro is here. I go from combing to picking.
You always push your jacket, the sleeves up. It's something you've always done.
You know, I'm glad only you could figure that out. You know what? It's an old 80s thing, if you notice anything correctly. It's one of my things where I can't talk like this. It always just feels better if I'm having a conversation. It's like crossing your legs, you know?
Every singular artist should have a thing, and that's your thing, Lionel.
This pushing is my those. Thing.
Yeah. Lionel, yeah. I know you're going to be singing on the American Idol finale. You're going to be singing We Are the World, which is very exciting to me. I'm wondering how this is going to work. Will the contestants be part of this? Will Katy Perry? Will Luke be part of this? How is this going to work?
All of the above. And in fact, I was so excited about kind of presenting it to them because, you know, I've been asked 1,001 times, are you going to write another song for what's happening right now in the world? And my answer was exactly the lyrics that I would have written for the new song are in the old song called We Are the World. When Michael and I wrote We Are the World, it was to let everybody know that this, if we don't solve the problem over there, it's going to be over here. And sure enough, 35 years later, it's now over here. And so the lyrics work perfectly. And of course, when I announced that we're going to do it with the kids on the show, with Katie and Luke and everybody, it just feels right that we were presented at this time.
Yes, one of the lines is we're saving our own lives.
Is it
true that you wrote almost that whole song and Michael really barely did anything on that that one?
No, that's not true.
I made that up. I don't know.
Of course you did.
I watched it last night because I was thinking about you. It might be the greatest 8 minutes in the history of the 80s. I mean, it is incredible to watch. And I know, you know, I feel like you, as you know, I love Kenny Rogers. I love Kenny Rogers. And I know he was a very great friend of yours. And I feel like because of what was going on in the news that his passing was overshadowed. Can you tell us one story about Kenny, something personal that might make us remember him fondly?
Well, let me tell you something. Kenny Rogers was, he liked me to say his older brother. I like to say he was my dad, you know, because he was really one of the greatest guys in the world. His sense of humor was just crazy. And I did not know when I walked into his camp for the first time while I was recording Lady, I didn't know that there's certain things you don't say to Mr. Rogers.
Oh,
and so I'm walking in as a Commodore, right? And of course, Kenny announced right as he walked in the studio, I'm going to only sing it 3 times, and then I'm going to leave and go back to play tennis. And I said to him, well, it's going to be your career and my reputation, So why don't you come back when you have enough time to get a hit record? Jimmy, there was dead silence in that recording studio. And you know how you know you said something wrong, but you're not quite sure how bad it's going to be? So he said, well, how long do you think it's going to take, Lionel? I said, until we get a hit record. And he said, okay, I'll be back in 2 hours. And he left to play tennis and to come back. But when he came back with a vengeance. And it took us a day and a half to get it right.
Lionel, was he wearing the tennis outfit when he sang, I'm your knight in shining armor and I love you?
That is great.
I mean, you're going deep. You're going deep on this.
I like to imagine he's got wristbands on. Maybe he's holding the racket while he's singing.
A pair of white shorts. And by the way, he could dress the part now and could play very well. But, you know, that's not what you think about when you think of a rock and roll singer in the studio struggling to get that hit record. But he was in his tennis gear.
He was great. I had him on the show once, and I love talking to him.
It's
so much fun. And I love that the two of you are friends. Now, let's talk about our charity here tonight. Each night I've been making a donation to a charity of our guest choosing. You chose the NAACP.
NAACP and BET got together. What's happening, and I must tell you, the black community has been devastated by this pandemic. And so I'm so concerned that there's so much to be done in the community that I thought this would be the perfect charity to kind of put that donation into. It's very necessary right now to be aware.
It is.
To be aware of what's going on out there.
Go to NAACP.org/coronavirus to help. Lionel, the Big American Idol finale is on Sunday night. I hope you grow I would love to see the Afro real big next time. I think you could start something all over again. Lionel Richie, everybody. Thank you, Lionel. Take care.
Okay, man. Bye-bye.